Hey everyone, I've got the Hyundai Santa Fe 2017 with push button or smart key system. So what I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna take you guys for checking how to manage the smart key system in the scan tool, what options we have, how we can test the components using the scan tool. Okay, let's start. I hooked up the scan tool already, and my scan tool is ready to go. Okay, let's start. Let's see what we got in the scan tool for this car, Hyundai export. And let's look for this car, Santa Fe DM 2017. Look for smart key system. Which is this one. So I've got two options here, smart key code saving and a smart key unit. Smart key code saving is for relearning the new fob key, and a smart key unit is all other functions that you've got in the smart key system. So if you need to relearn a new fob key, you have to use these options. But if you're trying to read the fault code or do the actuation test or neutralize, every other functions are gonna be here. So I open the smart key unit. Okay, so these are all options I've got here. Let's start one by one to see which one is which. The first one, diagnostic trouble codes, obviously is for reading any possible fault codes. The other one, number two, is for erasing the fault codes. I've got the parameters. You can check all the parameters, all data for smart key system here. Actuator test. There are some actuator tests for the smart key system. If I open it, you're gonna see a list. SSB is for start stop button. Obviously you have a couple of options for SSB or start button LEDs. This one is for ESCL enable, for enabling the steering column lock. We've got a couple of relays, ACC relay, IG on relay, IG on, IGN2 relay, and a starter relay. You can activate the relays from here. External buzzer, SSB LED off to turn it off. And you've got some options for checking the low frequency antenna. You have another option to check the antennas as well. Let's try a couple of them to see how they work. So for example, if I go for external buzzer, I need to press enter. So you see the condition is ignition must be off here, and activation is 1 second on, 1 second off, and it's gonna run 5 times. Okay, so I turn the ignition off and then I press start, and then I press start. You hear it? It's working right now. I can hear it, but because it's obviously outside, you guys may, it's maybe it's difficult for you guys to hear it. I press stop. I test another one, IGN1 relay. Okay, so ignition is off. I'm gonna test IGN1 relay, and when I press this one, I'm gonna show you how instrument cluster is gonna change. Now, see? It activates the IGN1 relay 5 times. Okay, this is the actuation test. You can do it for other function as well. Let's go back. The next one, number 5, is fob key check. You can check your fob key if the fob key that you've got is already lent, or sometimes you can't turn the ignition on, or you've got some other problems. So you can check the fob key by this one, by this function. So this function is to current teaching of fob key and learned status. Obviously you are checking, you're not gonna learn it, you're just checking your fob key. So condition is ignition off, place key or transport it to SSB area, but avoid pressing the start button, okay? If you got a fob key holder, on some cars you got fob key holder, you need to put the smart key or fob key inside the fob key holder. But because this car doesn't have fob key holder, you just need to place it close to the start button. And obviously ignition is off. I just place it here, okay? I just try to place it close to that. Okay, like this. And I press the enter. See, this key is successfully learned. So it means that keys already learned. So this is how I test my fob key using the scan. What are the other functions? Number 6 is serial communication line checks. If I open this one, I'm gonna see two functions. One is for receiver communication line checks, because I've got one RF receiver, radio frequency receiver in the car. So by doing this one, I can check actually the communication line between the smart key unit and the radio frequency receiver. And the other one, number 2, is ESCL or electronic steering column lock communication line, which is between the steering column lock and the smart key unit. So if I go for number 1, ignition must be off, fob key must be out. It means if you have the holder, it shouldn't be inside the holder. And I press enter. Completed. It means that the communication line between the RF receiver and the smart key unit is working perfectly. If there was any sort of problem, you had the test fail message right now. So you can do the same thing in this menu for electronic steering column lock. Neutralization mode. This neutralization mode is actually for neutralizing the engine control module, a smart key control module, and electronic steering column lock. So for early generation of smart key in Kia Hyundai, you had another option, which was called PDM, power distribution module. But because this car doesn't have PDM, so you have three options. You can neutralize any of these three. Some guys that they do neutralization before teaching a key, but you don't need to. Normally I do the neutralization. Sometimes when I want to actually swap the smart key from one car to the other one just for test, or sometimes when I have some other faults, I neutralize and do the key teaching after that. So for neutralization, it's not really complicated. For example, for a smart key, if you want to do the neutralization, you just open it and you need to insert a 6-digit of the PIN code that you can get from the dealership. Okay, as soon as when ignition is off, as soon as I enter the PIN code, which is a 6-digit PIN code, as soon as I enter the 6-digit PIN code, that's it. I'm gonna have the smart key neutralized. SMK status info. This is the smart key control module status information. If I open it, number of coded keys. It means that two keys already coded or learned for the smart key module. And status is learned. It means that smart key unit is already learned. If you have the neutralized smart key, here you have neutralized. Okay, or if you have the brand new one, you're gonna have virgin. It means that the smart key is the brand new one and never coded before. Next one is ESCL status info for steering column lock. So see, enable signal is off. So anytime you press the start button, you have a enable signal sent to this ESCL. Obviously is unlocked right now. And ESCL learning status is normal. If you neutralize it, you see neutralize here instead of normal. okay? ESCL open status check. This one is for checking the ESCL if it's open or not. Ignition key must be off, which is off already. If you have the holder, ignition key shouldn't be inside the holder, and you press the enter and you see test completed. It means that there is nothing wrong with the ESCL or steering column lock right now. Fob key status information. This one is for checking the fob key status. It's normal, and button status means this one's the last one that you press was unlocked. So if I press lock, which is the top one, see, I get lock. If I press unlock, it changes to unlock. This is how you check if the fob key or the remote function on the fob key is working or no. And the last one is for antenna status check. So you know, on this, in the smart key system on Hyundai and Kia, we have several low frequency antennas to actually detect the fob key. Okay, so because you don't need to use the fob key manually, you don't need to do that anytime you want to actually open the door or unlock the door, you want to unlock the door, or you want to turn the ignition on or off, you just need to actually have the fob key. So these low frequency antennas, they're going to locate, they're going to detect the fob key. So how can we test them? You have different low frequency antennas on this car 6. Interior antenna number 1 and 2, these two are located under the center console, one in the front side, one in the rear side. Number 3 in this car is on the boot area. Number 4, there is another low frequency antenna inside the rear bumper. Just in case you need to open the rear, you need to open the boot, that one is going to work to detect the key. And there is one low frequency antenna inside the driver door handle and another one on the passenger side, in case that you want to unlock or lock the door by pressing the button, lock button on the door handles. So for testing any of them, like for interior antenna, for testing any of these antennas, you need to turn the ignition off and place the fob key at that area. Like for interior antenna number 1, see, ignition must be off, and locate the fob key at interior antenna 1 area, which is between the ashtray and shifter. So this is my fob key. I put it exactly in front of the shifter and I'm gonna press enter. See what's gonna happen. Completed. When you get completed, it means that antenna is working, okay, because that low frequency antenna is already activated and send the low frequency to the fob key. So it means that this one is working. We can go back, we can do the same thing for all other antennas as well. But what happens if one of your antennas not working? What sort of message you're gonna get? Let's do it for, because we are inside the car. Obviously, if you do the same test for door handle antenna, and we don't place the fob key over there, let's see what's gonna happen. So I'm trying to simulate the condition when your door handle antenna is not working. Okay, so this one is asking us to turn the ignition key off, which is off already, and we need to place the fob key at the driver door handle area from the outside. Obviously, I press enter and you see test fails. Okay, but what's gonna happen if I do the same thing? Okay, I do the same thing, but this time I turn the ignition on, okay, and I open the window, so I'm gonna have access to the outside, to the driver door handle right here, so I can place the fob key near the driver door handle and to the front. driver door handle. I'm gonna turn the ignition off. And this is my fob key. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just keep the fob key next to the driver door handle antenna. I'm not gonna push anything, I just keep it here next to the driver door handle antenna.
Okay, I place the fob key over the driver door handle antenna. I'm gonna need my other hand to press the enter. So ignition is keys off. Completed, see? This is what actually we're gonna get. If I do the same thing for passenger door handle antenna or rear bumper, I'm gonna exactly get the same thing. What's the procedure to check the smart key system, low frequency antenna, which is applicable for all Hyundai and Kia cars.